Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Dr. Deborah Lee Davis, PhD, MPH, one of the leading experts on microwave radiation and what it's doing to the brain. That's becoming ubiquitous in our culture now and clearly causing developmental problems that they know the cell phones and tablets are just brain damaging children. That's on record. That's all over the news. But still, nothing's being done. There's no scientific body that looks at what it's specifically doing. Again, cell phones are at the same frequency oscillation, as she was saying, as microwave ovens, meant to get the molecules jumping around. It was invented when troops were using microwave relay systems to heat their food. We showed that on screen earlier, the official history of it. So she's now announced a plan to try to get an initiative going, which we've been part of for about 4 years, to get an initiative for $3 billion to harden the power systems with backup transformers. So if there's a big solar flare, we won't go back to the Stone Ages. That's now, Congress is now looking at that. So there are things we can do. And in closing, Dr. Davis, we'll try to get an article out by tomorrow on what you're calling for here with this video that we're going to then be taking from this live radio show and posting to that article. What more can you say to folks about getting behind this initiative that you're announcing here today?
Well, you are amazing because, frankly, as I was saying at the start of the break, I'm the scientist. I can recognize what we need. I don't know how to make it happen. I completely support your call for a hardened system for the grid. And I would add, it is absolutely insane that we are expanding the use of wireless for businesses right now, because in general, it makes us more vulnerable to many things. It makes us vulnerable to hacking. It's slower. And it endangers our health over the long term. And in fact, it has an effect on wildlife, and including migration and bees that we just aren't fully understanding. What we can do right now is very simple. Remember, distance is your friend. That's the basic idea. You can use these devices, like mine right now is sitting on my table. I wired in it with a headset. If you have a wired headset, do not keep the phone on your body in your pocket, because then it's just transmitting into you. In fact, the amount of radiation from your phone that gets into you when it's in your pocket is 2 to 4 times greater than when it's smacked against your head. So right now, we know what to do. Distance is your friend. When a phone is in an area where the signals are weak, you will notice that your battery drains more quickly. That's because the phone is smart. It's programmed to seek a signal. It's draining the battery. When a signal is weak, don't use it unless it's an emergency, because it will drain the battery. And if it's next to your body, it drains it right into you, because cell phone antennas are symmetrical. I am pleased that a number of people in and outside of the government and private sector recognize the importance of trying to reduce this radiation now. And I think that we're going to see soon major manufacturers stepping forward and saying, we now have a safer phone. It's just like cars today. There's no such thing as a safe car. Cars kill people. Well, we have made them safer. They have airbags, seat belts, etc. You would never think of putting a young baby into the front seat of a car anymore. Those kinds of things have resulted in safer cars. We need seat belts and airbags for our phones today. We need to design them with smarter systems for operating and smarter hardware as well. And there are a lot of things that we can do to protect ourselves in the meantime, certainly starting with not having very young children, pregnant women, using phones. And men who want to become fathers need to know you don't keep a phone in your pocket when you're trying to make a healthy baby, because cell phone radiation damages sperm count and quality.
All right. Well, great job, Dr. Davis. We look forward to having you back for a full hour as soon as you want to, try to really warn people, because I want to do something about this. because I don't want to see my children die of brain cancer. I don't want to just be roasted by all this Wi-Fi and all these smart meters they're trying to make people take. We've got to step up, and this is a civil rights issue. Thank you so much.
It is indeed. Thank you, Alex.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
I don't know what it is. Ralph just won't pay any attention to me. When he comes home from work, all he ever does is play video games and go to sleep. It's like I don't even exist.
Oh, baby.
Every single day. If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.